So in this video, we're going to think about the process of gene expression, so going from DNA to a functional protein inside the cell. And we're going to be thinking about this in the eukaryotes. The process is broadly similar in the prokaryotes, but there are some key differences, so I'm going to think mostly about the eukaryotes. So, if we're going to think about gene expression, we obviously need to start off with some DNA, which, as we know, is in the form of the double helix. So we have a helical structure there. So that's our DNA. So we've got a double-stranded molecule. And within that DNA sequence, so DNA is just endless bases of ATC, GTTC, GTC, AC, it goes on and on for forever, effectively. But within those sequences, we find regions which we call genes. And a gene is made up of two parts. So the first part of a gene is what we call an open reading frame. Which is sometimes known as an ORF. And if we're thinking about a protein coding gene, not all genes encode proteins, but most do, that's the bit that's actually going to give us the eventual protein sequence. But we also, upstream, we have a region called a promoter, which is effectively a switch or a control region. So we have two bits, and we need both bits to be a functional gene. So you have to have the functional product, so that's the open reading frame, but you also have to have a switch or a promoter, which is the regulatory region that determines whether that gene is going to be switched on or not, which we call gene expression. So what happens is that when it's time for a gene to be activated, then what you get is binding to this promoter region is you get a bunch of proteins coming in, and those proteins are called transcription factors. So those proteins come in, they bind particular sequences in the promoter region. And what that says is please switch the gene on in this case. You can have them switch genes off, but we'll think about genes being switched on. So what happens as a result of those transcription factors binding, a whole host of proteins bind, and then what you get is an unwinding of the DNA in that region. So here's our transcription factors at the promoter. And what they do is to recruit a protein, really important protein called an RNA polymerase. And it's the job of that polymerase to make a molecule of RNA. So polymerase means to just add one subunit after another to make chains of a new sequence. So why has the DNA unwrapped? Well, the DNA is unwrapped to expose all of the bases. So each one of those little dots there is either an A, T, a C, or a G. So it's one of those nucleotide bases. So we unwrap the DNA to expose those bases. And then what the RNA polymerase does is it moves along that DNA. And each time it does so, it adds a base to a new molecule of RNA. So there's the first base, there's the second base, there's the third base. So eventually we go along and we make an RNA copy of that piece of DNA. So we've made a new molecule of RNA. That can then dissociate from the DNA. The DNA zips back up again. So we've got our molecule of RNA, and we call this the nascent RNA. So just kind of hot off the press, here's our molecule of RNA. So it's got all of its bases on there, which in RNA are AUC and G. So T becomes a U in RNA. So now we've got our molecule of RNA, but in a eukaryote, before we do anything with that RNA, we have some RNA processing reactions. So there's three key reactions that happen. So the first is a reaction called splicing. So in the RNA, in that open reading frame, in a eukaryote, this doesn't happen in prokaryotes, but in eukaryotes, that open reading frame might be divided up into regions called exons and introns. So the exon is the coding bit. So that's got kind of useful sequence in it. The intron is non-coding. So within the gene, there are these intron regions which actually aren't very useful to us. They don't end up making any protein. So what happens is the first thing to happen is a reaction called splicing, where basically those introns get cut out. So now we have, so in this case we had three exons, one, two, three. The introns have been cut out, so now all the exons are next to each other. So the RNA has been shortened. There are still bits of sequence either side of that open reading frame. The two ends also get processed. So we call the two ends the 5' prime end and the 3' prime end. The 3' prime end, what we end up doing is to put a whole load of A residues on it. So that's a process called polyadenylation. So we have what's called the poly-A tail at the 3' prime end. And at the 5' prime end, there is a structure called a cap that gets added. So both ends of the RNA molecule have now been protected. So we now can call this a messenger RNA. And that's the kind of mature thing. So mRNA is messenger RNA. So we made an RNA copy from the DNA double helix. We've done some processing reactions. So we've spliced, we've polyadenylated, and we've put the 5' cap on. That processed RNA is now ready to leave the nucleus. So all of this up to now has been happening inside the nucleus. But now that mRNA molecule is ready to go out into the cytosol. So now we've got our mRNA. It's got its poly-A tail. It's got its cap. And it's got those exons all next to each other. And those are the bits that are going to form the protein. So this process copying up here, that was the process of transcription. We then had processing. And those were all RNA-based processes. But now we're going to have another process, which is the process of translation. So from translation, we go from mRNA to protein. Transcription is DNA to RNA. So with our translation process, the most important thing is the ribosome. So the ribosome has two subunits. It has a large and a small subunit. And in a eukaryote, it binds to the 5' cap. It then moves along your molecule of RNA until it finds a start sequence. And that start sequence is always AUG. So it scans along, finds the first AUG, and that defines where it starts to do the process of translation, where what we do is we use the bases on the RNA to then make or to align a whole series of amino acids. So we have three bases is a codon, and that gives you an amino acid, and I'll explain that in more detail in another video. So we then have amino acids that we make a chain of amino acids, which is called a protein, and then that protein can fold to give us the mature protein that does something inside the cell. So there's quite a lot of steps involved. So we start off with transcription. So we use the promoter to define where the gene is and whether the gene should be switched on or off. So the transcription factors result in the unwinding of the DNA so that the RNA polymerase can come in. The RNA polymerase makes an RNA copy. There's then various different processing reactions that happen in there. So there's splicing, there's the 5' cap, there's the poly A tail. Once the mRNA is ready, it leaves the nucleus, goes into the cytosol, where it gets translated using the ribosome. And that ribosome uses the sequence of nucleotides in the mRNA to make an eventual protein in the cytosol. So that's an overview of the process. There's a second video to have a look at of thinking about this at a more sequence specific level. So each base I've given here, I've just put a little line. There's another video that explains this, thinking about what's actually happening to our A's, T's, C's and G's. So in order that we go from a gene sequence to a protein sequence.